Companies approach me to ask how they can develop inspiring leaders. Individuals in my program confess that they want to become inspiring leaders. In my book, if you want to be an inspiring leader, then you are already on the wrong path. This is because the emphasis is me-centered. What I'm really saying is that I want people to do what I would like them to do, which perhaps they don't want to do. So I have to figure out how to get people to do what I want them to do when they don't want to do it, which is another way of saying, I want to be good at manipulating people. This is not nice. My view is that being an inspiring leader is not an aspirational goal, it is a byproduct. You have to be personally inspired by a grand vision, one that brings a greater good to a greater community, a vision that calls to you so strongly that you're willing to devote a big chunk of your life to achieving it. If you are so inspired and learn to communicate this vision, then you become an inspiring leader by default. Whoever comes in contact with you will become inspired because he or she cannot help it. When Gandhi started his work in South Africa, he did not set out to inspire millions of people and become a great leader. He started because he believed that the passport laws were unjust and he could not let them stand. He was a British-trained attorney with good verbal skills, and he used these and other talents to mobilize support for this cause. Because of this, and his later effort to end colonial rule in India, he did in fact become an inspiring leader and continues to inspire millions decades after his assassination. If you want to become an inspiring leader, then first be deeply inspired.